of the last goal in this match and of their own. And what a fitting end to this week's exciting interdepartment. The finals between old-time rivals, self-defense cell and the youth outfield. SD cell, led by the batsman strike Shamshir Singh Tomar, has won the last five tournaments largely because of Shamshir's scintillating back. Spooked for 9 minutes. But will he be able to pull it off again? Or will he run out of bats? So last wicket, last over and 2 runs to win. All he has to do is to hit the ball in the gap and take 2. Or maybe a ground story for a 4. But let's wait and see what he does. Here comes 4 runs. Down is long runner. Right arm over the wicket. Good length ball. And Shamshir Singh steps up and slaps the ball right over the ball.
What's for breakfast?
Aloo ke parathe.
Kya baat?
Chabi, tere bhaiya ko come down, to parathas are getting cold.
Bhaiya, come down right now, otherwise I'll eat your parathas. 30 seconds will be at the table.
Acha, go to the kitchen and get an apple for Papa. Go.
Knife, please.
It's right there.
No, it's not.
Oh, how do you always know? You didn't even lift your eyes from the newspaper.
Because you always forget to bring the knife.
It's your fault, mommy. You always say, get an apple. Never get an apple and a knife.
Hey, how is it my fault? You should remember, no? You always forget.
But what's a knife needed for? It's an apple. Put it in your mouth, bite off a piece and enjoy. What is a knife needed for?
You know why. Papa likes to share the apple with the rest of the family.
But mommy, it's an Indian apple, it's tiny. If you slice it by 4, it's like dividing 0 by 4. Everyone gets a 0.
Chupka, it's a tradition in his family for generations.
Yeah, I know. But there should be a logic behind the tradition, no? If there is, I would like to know. Hey, Papa.
Traditions, Beta, are meant to be followed, not questioned. Traditions make a family more than just its living members. Handed down from generation to generation, traditions connect us to those that came before us and to those that will follow. I would be questioning the wisdom of my forefathers if I didn't follow our family traditions.
So what you're saying is, follow this tradition because it's a tradition.
Exactly.
But why this tradition?
What do you mean?
What if I don't like apples?
You do like them.
But then suppose, what if I don't like them?
That's not possible. Everyone likes apples.
What you really mean is every Cricketiya must like apples.
You're right. And there's nothing wrong with that. Cricket is our sacred sport, woven into the fabric of our culture. And the apple is a symbol of the sacred bond. For the devout, these symbols are important.
So after marriage, when I have to wear apples for my family?
Your husband's family will have their own traditions, you will follow them, just like your mother.
And what if he doesn't like apples?
Who?
My husband.
Impossible. Everyone likes that, as they should. You'll always find apples in every Cricketiya household.
Acha. But bhaiya has to follow the apple cutting tradition, no?
Absolutely. Good morning. We are honored that His Highness has decided to join us for breakfast.
Yes, sir.
Where are you going? You there today.
I'll watch the highlights later.
Oh, for have your tea at least. Come here.
Ravi beta, this is not right. Your interest in cricket seems to be fading.
No, Papa. The chances are right with you, no? But the interdepartmental tournament.
It was different. I'm talking about BCCI cricket, the most sacred form of our sport. Stop going to the stadium and now your auntie went watching it on TV.
No, Daddy. I go to the stadium sometimes with my friends.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
How about I go with you next Sunday, okay?
Okay.
Can I please go now?
Okay, okay, bye.
Mommy, I'll be back by 7, so please don't call me before that to ask me when I'm back. Bye, Bhaiya.
Oh, oh, she forgot her phone. Deepak, ja beta, run after her and give her her phone.
She'll come back for it.
But what if she doesn't realize she doesn't have it?
She can't last 5 minutes without checking her phone.
You look so tired, beta. When did you sleep last night?
Late.
What do you do staying up half the night, Deepak?
Read.
Reading what? Please do share.
He must be reading for his IAS exams, no?
Is that so? Well, what's the name of the book? I think we all like to know.
The Collected Works of Bertrand Russell.
Sorry, can you speak louder?
The Collected Works of Bertrand Russell.
I see. So this is for your philosophy options. If it is, then I have to say that this style of your studying is not a very efficient one. Especially if the study is, if the subject is Russell's law.
I'm interested in the subject, Papa. What's wrong with that? At least I'm not doing drugs.
Gigi, you would never do something like that. I mean, let it go, na. So what if he is reading that book? You have only encouraged the children to read.
Well, of course he should read. But if his goal is to get into the IAS, then he should not get distracted.
That is true, beta. All our Cricketiya gods have focus. Viratji says, anything you want to do in life, do it with full passion and work really hard. Focus!
How do I focus? I just don't have the motivation. I don't think I'll qualify.
Nonsense. Why do you think like that? So you didn't make it last year. So what? So many people make it on their second attempt.
I don't think I can, Papa.
Then why are you wasting your time?
Because you're making me.
But it's for your own good, na, beta. You have to work hard. IAS is a good career.
But I should be interested in the career, no.
So then what will you do?
I don't know. I haven't thought about it.
Don't worry. Papa will get you a job in the media.
I can. But so far, whenever we have talked about it, he has shown zero interest. Look, beta. You insisted on doing arts. Really? Then you said you wanted to do an MA. He said, fine. Didn't? Now please do this for us. Get a job. Doesn't matter if it's small, part-time, anything. Just do something.
I mean, he's trying. Hey, na, beta. Abhi, if he's not interested in this IAS line, what can he do?
2 years of hard work and nothing to show for. Not interested, he says. Is he interested in anything? Any kind of job?
It'll happen. He's just waiting for the right job to come.
And what is this right job? What does it look like? Please enlighten me. Offered my help so many times. I know a few people in the print media, TV news channels. It's easy for me to make a few phone calls and get him a break. These jobs, they are beneath his dignity.
That's right. I don't want to work in media.
Why? What's wrong with that?
Because it's a corrupt industry. Every news channel, every newspaper is either owned by a politician's family or an industrialist. Between licking the boots of the owners and running after clicks and TRP ratings, there's no room of doing anything meaningful. For even facts or the truth.
Hey, beta, but you have to do some job, no? Papa is at a senior post in the party. If he can help.
Senior post. He manages Delhi sector in the SDCL of Vibha party.
Yes, that's a big job.
Bimla.
Spreading lies and falsehood, destroying the reputation of people who oppose the Vibha party. That's what SDCL does.
Beta, his team is responsible for coordinating thousands of social media accounts. He gets to talk to the ministers.
Bimla! You don't have to defend me or my job. Please, I'm not sitting at home freeloading off of my parents.
Come on, Deepak. Go say sorry to your papa. Go, Deepak, say sorry to your papa. Ja, beta.
Sorry, papa.
Beta, my job, what I do, it puts food on the table for this family. I'm proud of my job. This country, our culture, cricket is its life force, the sport of our ancestors. It is in our blood. These other sports, they're ruining the unity of our country. They're everywhere, sprouting like mushrooms. Schools stadium, school grounds, TV. They all like to build their own sport faith communities by converting the Cricketiya field.
Achana, enough!
But it won't happen. You know why? Because of the party. As long as Virat Bharat Party is in power, we will withstand all attacks on cricket. The political battle to keep the party in power is the most important thing in this holy war to save cricket. And in this holy war, information is a weapon. And you know who wields these weapons? Us. Me and my self-defense cell team. Son! Mock me as much as you want, I don't care. Let me tell you something. The right to criticize does not come free. You have to earn it. Have you earned it? Have you earned anything?
Did you have to say that to him? He is such a good boy. If he wants to make his own future for himself, what's wrong in that?
It's not that, Vimla. It's just both our children. They don't seem to care about cricket, our culture. Why is that? Did we not raise them right?
Oh, Faust, stop thinking like that. Just wait till they get married and have their own families. They'll all come in line. This tradition, culture matter a lot more when you have your own children.
I hope so. Right now it seems like Deepak is going to teach philosophy, not cricket, to his children. Complete works of Burt and Russell.
And if those are the bedtime stories he tells his children, they will fall asleep in 10 seconds.
And it will take 40 years to complete one book.
Someone is sending text messages to Chavi. Did you hear what I said?
What?
Someone is sending text messages to Chavi.
What texts?
Where are you? Dying to see you. Why are you not replying to my messages? Are you angry about yesterday? And then there is a missed call. But she was home yesterday.
They must have had a fight on texts. That's what people do nowadays. Fight with friends and family on texts and with strangers on social media.
I don't like this.
What's the name of the friend?
There is no name, just a number.
What's the problem?
Don't you find it strange? If she is a close friend, shouldn't her name be on the contact? Well, there's one way to find out.
What?
I'll just call this number.
And what are you going to say?
Who's this? It's a man's voice.
What?
This is what I was afraid of.
What did he say?
Where are you, darling? And when he heard my voice, he cut the phone.
This is what she's up to. Missing a match to go meet some boy.
Don't worry. I will take care of this. We have given her too much freedom. That's going to change. And why does she need a Samsung smartphone? A 300 rupee iCall phone is just fine.
You're overreacting, Bimla.
She comes and goes as she pleases. Well, not anymore. From now on, Saturday, Sundays, she'll sit at home or at the most go to the stadium to watch the game. And on the other days, she'll sit at home and study or watch game on TV.
Bimla!
And tell your network technician to come home this week. There is no need for that internet.
Can you please stop talking?
What?
She's a young woman. She'll naturally be interested in young men of her age. And they are meeting only, nothing else.
How do you know?
I know my daughter. She won't do anything that will put shame on her or us.
But how do you know?
Well, ask her about him then. But don't tell her anything before you've talked to her.
Sometimes I can't believe how naive you can be.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Writing down his number.
Why?
So you can give it to your SD cell people and they can find out who this fellow is, what he does and why he's meeting our daughter. What?
Okay, I'll find out. Before I make my inquiries, you will not punish Chavi or say anything to her. Innocent until proven guilty. Understood?
Fine.
So, how'd you like the movie?
Nice, you?
Oh, loved it. Jennifer Lawrence is a superb actor. And she's so hot.
I am a big fan.
Achcha. If you find a car hot, then why are you wasting your time with me?
No. She's hot, but nothing compared to me.
Right.
Okay. Arz kya hai? Jennifer Lawrence can go fly a kite. Jennifer Lawrence can go fly a kite. You photo color. She black and white.
My most sad Romeo. full marks. I have trained you well.
I live to serve, my lady.
Okay, okay. Let's move on.
Let's. How is the cappuccino?
Not enough sugar.
Okay, let me fix that.
Boss, you want a fat girlfriend or what?
I don't mind.
One track mind. What? Speak up. It's too noisy.
I love you.
So lovely.
You only told me to.
I didn't ask you to shout.
Darling, jo dar gaya, so mar gaya.
Yeah, yeah.
If you want me to, I'll even shout it out while standing on the table, shall I?
No, thank you.
No, I can do it. It's not a big deal.
Yes, we all know you're a modern day merchant.
Of course. I'm a Kabaddiya. No fear. We raid or we tackle. We don't do back foot defense and all. Like some people who will not mention.
Achcha. If you're such a big Kabaddiya, then why don't you go see your matches?
Why don't you go to your stadiums to watch your cricket games?
Abelu, if I went to watch the weekend cricket matches, who will come and meet you? My mother!
Oh,
use that brain of yours, Kabaddiya.
I am grateful for the sacrifice you are making.
Oh, you are grateful for the sacrifice. Why don't you go see your matches?
I do, once in a while.
In the last 4 years since we have met, you have not watched a single match apart from your PKL finals.
At least I go to the finals, no?
That means you are a fan, not a devotee.
Excuse me. With your Cricketiya party in power, even if I wanted to, I couldn't maintain my devotion. They have made it impossible by reserving the entire weekend for cricket. We Kabaddiyas have to fight our way through Russia traffic to get to weekday games.
What have we done? Give your matches in the weekend.
And what about TV coverage? All sports channels will be showing cricket only, no?
That's not our fault. Cricket is more popular.
I see. So minority sports can go jump in a lake. You know your Vibha party can fix this if they wanted to, but they don't. They just want to keep the TV coverage issue to a simmer. Whenever elections come close, turn the heat up.
Sounds like victimhood to me.
What? Hello, I'm not some victim shittim. I might not go to the games regularly, but I'm still a Kabaddiya through and through. I was born and raised in the Kabaddiya tradition and I'm proud of that.
Yes, darling. I was just joking. Give me your hand. I'm proud of you too. And I love this Kabaddiya.
Me too.
I love this Kabaddiya. Say
it. I love this Kabaddiya.
Come here. Thank you.
I don't care about Kabaddi as much as I care about you.
I know. We swore that we will never let our sacred sports come in between us. Till now, they haven't.
And they never will. Chavi, there's something I need to tell you.
Okay.
You won't like it.
It's okay, you can tell me.
You won't get angry, no?
Radeep?
I think your mother called me from your phone. I picked up and said, where are you, darling?
Wait, what? My mother called you from my phone?
Yeah, I thought it was you calling
me. And you picked up and said?
Where are you, darling?
Are you telling this to me now? After 4 hours?
It would have ruined the date, no. And you wouldn't have enjoyed the movie. And you know how stressed you get in all situations.
So shouldn't I be stressed, huh? Mommy, Papa now know that I'm meeting a boy who calls me darling. Shouldn't I be stressed?
Yeah, I suppose. I should also be stressed a little bit, no?
No. Why should you be stressed? You enjoy your movie and your hot Jennifer Lawrence. Then what did you say?
Jennifer Lawrence?
My mommy!
Oh.
You said that I'm darling, then what did you say?
She said, who is this? I disconnected the line.
I am dead. I am so dead.
No, baby, it's not that bad.
Give me your phone.
No, but...
Give it to me! Why did you have to send this stupid text? You must have seen this and she must have called.
So this is my fault. You are the one who left your phone at home.
But why did you have to send this lovey-dovey text?
Lovey-dovey? Are you angry about last night? This is lovey-dovey?
Of course.
You're just upset you made a mistake and you want to blame me for it.
I forgot my phone, okay? It happens.
And how many times I told you to turn off notifications?
So why didn't you turn it off yourself? Because of you only I got this stupid Samsung phone.
Okay, can we let it go, please? Look, it's going to be alright. You will tell your parents about me. They're going to be upset for a while. But after some time, it'll blow over. We knew this would happen someday. So, there's no place for fear when you're in love. Pyar kiya to darna kya? Huh? Say it. Just say it now.
Pyar kiya to darna kya?
Huh? Why are you so worried? It's gonna be alright.
Pradeep, you don't know my parents.
But you never introduced us.
Are you mad?
I know them reasonably well, I think.
You know nothing.
Your papa is a conservative cricketer, the Vibha party and cricket. He is devoted to both and that more or less defines him.
And mummy?
Mummy. Your mummy is a bit nutty. But she loves you very much.
Yes, she does. But sometimes she scares me. If you get onto her wrong side, she turns into a monster.
Really? That's strange. Her daughter is nothing like her.
I turn into a monster when I get angry?
No. Opposite. When you're angry, you're like a rude puppy.
Pradeep, do you think it's a good time to be making jokes?
What I say? Okay.
You're not taking this seriously. These are my parents, not like your mother, self-made, liberated woman. If they find out I'm meeting a Kabaddiya boy secretly, I don't know what they will do to me or to you.
What did I say? Pyar kiya to darna raha.
Can you stop copying all these cheesy Bollywood lines?
Okay, sorry.
And get some new lines here. I'm sick and tired of hearing the same lines over and over again.
See? Just like a cute puppy. Okay. Oh, come on. Don't cry. Okay, no more fooling, huh? Huh? I promise. Look, it's okay. Mistakes happen.
It's my own mistake.
Let's say it was. The point is, the time for lying to your parents is over. You have to come clean and then we'll see what happens.
And what if mommy papa lock me up in my room and never let me out again?
Well, then I'll just have to tear down the walls to your room with my bare hands, lift you over my shoulder and carry you away. Sorry, I didn't even think, it just came. Whatever happens to me, I know one thing. No one can keep us apart. Not even your papa and mommy.
No one. We should get going.
They're going home, right? Mom's at work. There's no one at home.
Not today, Pradeep. I wish I could. I'm not about to.
Long drive.
Okay.
And a long make out break on the teeth.
Short break.
Okay. Fine.
Pradeep?
Huh?
How come you've never lifted me on your shoulders before?
Can we go home?
No.
Please, yeah.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
No. Sir, report ready.
Arre va, paper report. You spoil me, Jyoti.
You're very busy, sir. Busy.
Stop calling me, sir. I'm your age.
You're my guru, sir.
Manager.
And I'm your student.
Trainee.
Theek hai, sir.
Again, sir.
Matlab, Samser ji.
Jyoti ji.
Haan, sir.
Such a thick report you made. What is there in it?
Please read it, sir. I have put a lot of work into it.
If I could read English that well, I would have done engineering, no?
Correct, sir.
Correct, sir. Give me summary.
Sirji, the phone number that Gupta sir gave us belongs to one Pradeep Sharma.
Achha.
Pradeep Sharma lives in Delhi only, Basab, Bihar. School Mother International, college Kirodiman. After college, he went to Australia to do MBA.
So he's the son of a rich father, huh?
No, sir. Father is dead. Mother is there. Kamini Sharma has a business.
Achha, father is dead. What business does mother have?
A retail chain.
What name?
Sanaya Bador.
Sanaya what?
Bador, sir. Huh. B-O-U-D-O-I-R. Bador?
What the hell is that?
I checked meaning in online dictionary. Something about the ladies' room. Not very clear.
Ajay, carry on. How many shops do they have?
Three. Connaught Place, South Extension, Gurgaon.
And what do they sell?
I don't know, sir.
What do you mean by I don't know, sir?
Meaning I know name of the product, I just don't know what it is.
If the customer does not understand the product, why will they buy it?
Sirji, on website, product is called lingri.
Lingri?
But it looks like ladies' underwear.
Ladies' underwear?
Huh, but very costly underwear, sir. Huh? All prices over 2000, 3000 only. Nobody pays that much for underwear, even rich ladies.
What is it called again? Sindri?
No, sir. Lingri. L-I-N-G-E-R-I-E. Lingri?
Who made these spellings, man? Must be drunk. Lingri. So they sell lingri, huh? I think I have heard about this product.
Sirji, on photos, models were wearing like underwear. Huh? Upper, lower,
And sometimes singer piece. Achha. And these models, are they Indian or white?
Indian, sir.
Indian?
Haan, sir. I was also shocked. I did not think our ladies will pose in underwear.
No, this is not right. Where are these photos?
Online store, sir. You can.
Yeah, give me the address, sir.
Address, Kanat Place wali store ka.
Bhavadi Pooch, give me the address of the online store.
Oh, www.address.
Write it here. I'll check your research later.
But sir, how can underwear be so expensive? Huh? And why would anyone pay so much money?
What is your age?
22, sir.
Have you done sex?
Huh?
Huh?
No, sir.
First you do sex, then you'll understand. And if you still don't, then I'll explain it to you. Okay, getting back to the report. So what does this Pradeep Sharma do?
I think he helped mother in business.
Friends?
Huh, many from his school, college.
Girlfriend?
No.
Cricketiya?
No, sir. Kabaddiya.
Kabaddiya?
Huh.
These Kabaddiyas, not many of them, but all of them are bloody rich. Anything else?
No, sir. Nothing else important. Rest of details in report.
So then the question is, why is this Vibha party interested in this Kabaddiya? Is he paying money to the opposition or is his mother?
From social media, doesn't seem to be interested in politics. Also not a bhakt of Kabaddi.
What college did you say?
Kirodiman.
Kirodiman. And when did he pass out?
6 years ago.
Oh, teri ki. There is a girl, Chavi Gupta. She is also from Kirodiman. She passed out 2 years after Pradeep. Find out if she and Pradeep have any connection. Dance, drama, student union, politics, anything.
Who is Chavi Gupta, sir?
You don't worry about that, Jyoti.
She's Gupta sir's daughter, na?
Yes, she's Gupta's daughter.
You know her, sir?
Oi! You do what I've asked you to do, okay? I've asked you to find the connection, you find the connection. And till you find it, keep your mouth shut. Got it? If Gupta ji's daughter is involved with the Kabaddiya, there is going to be huge trouble.
Ah, Samshir.
Jain sir.
Jain sir.
Jain, Jain. Did you find out about the number I gave you?
Yes sir, we got the name from our contact at the CBI. Here is the report Jyoti has made, sir.
Paper report? Wow.
Sir, it has all the details, social media, college, police record, everything we could find in the short time you gave us, sir.
How's your training coming along, Jyoti?
Very good, sir. Samshir sir has trained on everything.
Very bright boy, sir.
Good report. How many days left in your training?
This is last week, sir.
This Pradeep Sharma, he's a Kabaddiya?
Haan, sir.
Nothing very interesting. Party leader suspected that he was funding the opposition. Doesn't seem like it.
Sir, should we do some more investigation?
No, not necessary. I'll keep this report. You delete it from your computers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Actually, this was supposed to be top secret. I forgot to tell you.
No problem, sir.
Sanjay.
Yes, sir.
Tonight is the hockey tournament finals.
Yes, sir.
I have received orders that it should not end very peacefully.
Oh, I understood, sir. I'll take care of
good.
It.
Good.
Thank you, sir.
Jyoti, come see me next week. We'll talk about your next steps.
Thank you, sir. Jyoti ji, why are you staring at me like this?
Sarji, what did Gupta sir say in the end? I didn't quite understand.
You will. With time, you will. Just remember that this is the most important part of your training. The rest is just technical skills. This is the real work.
Achha. Can you provide details, sir?
So what did Gupta ji say at the end?
That he has received order that hockey tournament final should not end peacefully.
Correct. So how will the peace be disturbed?
I don't know, sir.
As soon as the final match ends, the supporters of both the teams will get into a fight. That fight will then become a riot.
How, sir? How do you know?
Because man is violent by nature. In every crowd, you'll find these young men who are just waiting for a chance to either break someone's bones or burn a car or two. Once the fight starts, they will all join it.
But how will the fight start, sir?
We will start it. Our Cricketiyas will.
Our Cricketiyas will be at hockey tournament final?
Why not? All it takes is 15 minutes on WhatsApp, Twitter, Facebook. By the evening, at least 50 Cricketiyas will be there at the hockey stadium with hockey sticks. And so when they show property damage on the morning news tomorrow, the media will blame the hockey fans, and then our job is done. Do you understand now, Jyoti ji?
Huh, sir, I think so. But you think this is right, sir? All this violence and property destruction?
But Jay, this is called politics. The hockey fans have a reputation for violence. They take out their hockey sticks at the slightest excuse. We are just adding to their reputation.
But this is wrong, sir. They suffer, but country also suffers.
Achha, so now you feel this is wrong? Then what are you even doing here? Do you remember your oath?
I remember, sir. Glory of cricket, progress of nation, and victory of Vibha.
So then?
But by persuading people with better ideas, not by damaging property, destroying reputation of rival. This is not right, sir.
Look, we have to do all of this to keep the Vibha party in power. When they are in power, they will take care of the country and Cricketiyas everywhere. Haven't you heard of the saying, all is fair in love, war and politics? I have to go now.
But sir, if our party wins this way, you really think this is okay?
Look, there'll just be a little bit of property damage. No one is going to get hurt seriously. So what is your problem?
Well, that's what you said. Also, I just
got it.
Already.
Are I have some more. Just a small piece, please. Thank you. Are eat.
They're homemade, Kamini ji. Nothing will happen if you have a little more.
Looks like we won't be eating dinner tonight then.
Auntie, I only made the dahi badas.
Oh. That's right. Of course, Beta. When your mother is such a good cook, the apple can't fall far from the tree.
Dahi badas. Harry, she won't even enter the kitchen.
Oh, God knows, I've tried with Pradeep as well, but so far I can only get him to make tea.
What form? You forgot my world famous masala omelette.
For which I have to chop the onions and tomatoes.
But you must have cook shook, no?
Yes, but I like to cook myself 2 or 3 times a week. It would be more, but it's hard to find the time with the business.
What are your food preparations like?
Oh, like this only, like your food. We're also from Delhi.
But non-vegetarian, so meat sheet and all.
No, not every day. I have to tell you, the first time Shadi came home, the cook had made chicken for dinner. She refused to even sit at the table till it was taken away. After that, it's always been vegetarian food whenever she's come home.
Our children are rooted in their Sanskriti, in their culture. For generations, no one has eaten non-veg in our house. Like all Cricketiya families.
Except Bhaiya, of course.
Let's not talk about him.
Who, your son?
Yes.
Oh, where is he? I hope we get to meet Shadi's only brother.
Well, he had to go somewhere. So, when was the first time you met Shadi?
Maybe 2 years ago. When their relationship first got serious. Mm-hmm. Can I just say your daughter is an absolute gem. So beautiful and just so sweet. I don't know about Pradeep, but I'm definitely in love with her.
So since the first time you met her, how many times has she come to your house?
I don't know. I mean, not exactly.
But you must have some idea, no?
I suppose every month, at least once a month.
Achcha.
So Kamini ji, you and your late husband, both families must have been Kabaddiya only, no?
My side of the family was. My husband wasn't very interested in sports.
He was a renouncer?
Yes.
Achha. What job did he do?
He was a professor of philosophy in Delhi University.
Auntie, Bhaiya has also got his MA in philosophy.
Is that right? Then Sanjay and Deepak would have gotten along famously.
I don't think so. Deepak is interested in cricket.
No, mummy, not really. He's very much into philosophy.
Go get some barfi.
And your parents, Kamini ji? They must have been Kabaddi, of course, both of them.
My mother was a state-level player. She represented Delhi in the junior nationals.
And your father?
He converted to Kabaddi after meeting my mother.
Converted? From what sport?
Cricket.
Are wah! Then he must have been completely in love with her, no?
He was, but he was also a man who knew his mind. He was intelligent and kind, and Kabaddi's simplicity appealed to him.
So it's natural for an intelligent man to convert to Kabaddi. Is that what you're saying?
No, that's not at all what I was saying.
So your father's side of the family was Cricketiya, and your mother's side as well.
Yes.
Your mother's ancestors also must have been Cricketiya at some point.
Yes, my maternal grandparents were actually instrumental in the creation of the faith. They met during the reform movement.
Really? You must know a lot about your sacred sport.
I do. I grew up living very close to them, so I was initiated into the faith early on. But over time, things have changed. Life has gotten so busy, I just don't get the time to go to the games anymore. But I still try and follow the guiding principles.
And what are these guiding principles?
I'm sure you know, Guptaji. Faith is personal, rituals are unnecessary, the chain is stronger than the individual, and live simply.
Simple living? You really believe in it?
Well, over time, things have been extended, reinterpreted, right or wrong. Human beings tend to seek out material comfort, and money can bring that comfort. Now, simple living is more about simple thinking.
Very nice. Aminiji, let me ask you a question. How many Kabaddiyas do you think there are in the Delhi NCR area, total?
I don't know. Pradeep?
About 40,000 or so.
So you're saying that in the birthplace of the Kabaddiya sport faith, in a city of 5 crore population, there are just 40,000 Kabaddiyas?
I suppose so.
Do you then say that your sport faith is a failure? I mean, it's been 80 years. Less than 0.1% of Delhi NCR is Kabaddiya. Isn't this a failure?
Maybe, but makes no difference to us.
Kabaddi is a beautiful game, Uncle. Simple rules, complex strategies to win, just like the sport faith itself. Come with me sometime to a game.
Doesn't it bother you that your sport faith is a failure?
No, but it looks like it bothers you.
Papa, can we please talk about something?
Why
else?
Should it bother us? Sacred sport of cricket is strong and has endured for decades. 2/3 of India's population is of the Cricketiya sport faith. We don't worry about such small regional sports faiths.
It is not the lion that the elephant fears, Guptaji, it is the ant. We may be ants, but our very existence bothers you a lot more than the older sports faiths like hockey.
Why should it bother us?
Because Kabaddi arose from the need for reform in cricket. Cricket had become too ritualistic. Too much money led to corruption right at the top.
Nonsense! Cricket is the sport of Sachin, Dhoni, Virat. It is perfect in its form. It has never needed reform, nor will it ever.
If you say so.
Have you heard of Dinkar Asthana?
Yes, he was the founder of our sports faith.
Did you know that before he founded your sports faith, he was the vice president of BCCI?
Yes, I'm aware.
Then you must also know that he was expelled from BCCI due to corruption.
I've heard this fake news. Vibhapati's Cricketiya supporters never tire of lying to pull us down. We've given them plenty of documentary evidence to refute their claims, but in this new world we're living in, lies never seem to die out. They just fly from one place to the other on the internet and roost away.
Mom, give me a little more, please.
It's okay, beta.
You promised.
It's okay. It's just a conversation about politics.
Papa, can you please talk about something else, please?
Some things need to be said.
Where is Deepa? Will we get to meet him?
Probably not. He's gone out for some work.
Papa, why did you have to send him out today?
There was some work.
What does he do?
Auntie, he reads all day. This fat books about philosophy and whatnot.
He is studying for his IAS exams.
Very nice.
We are the salaried class, Kamiji. We don't have a family business to hand over to our son.
Oh, I believe very much in the importance of job experience, Guptaji. In fact, when Pradeep got back from Australia with his MBA, I very much wanted him to do a job, and he could have easily gotten one, but he just wasn't interested.
Don't listen to our uncle. When I got back from Australia, Shania was growing like crazy. Mom would come back home every day evening and complain about some late shipment from a supplier or a bad review from Google. I finally took pity on her and joined the business.
Of course. You're my savior.
Absolutely.
So Kaminiji, I have heard that in your faith, there are no statues or images of God.
That is correct, Vimlaji.
So then where do you pray?
Anywhere. You just have to close your eyes and pray.
Anywhere? Even in the toilet?
Mommy?
What did you say was the name of your business, Kaminiji?
Shania.
What does that word mean?
No particular meaning.
What's the business about?
Lingerie.
A lady's underwear?
Something like that.
Mommy, you leave it. It's nothing you will appreciate.
And neither should you. Anyway, who's going to pay 2,000-3,000 rupees for such an obscene item?
Mommy.
So in the Kabaddiya sport faith, doing business in such vulgar things is encouraged.
Papa,
Chukka.
There is nothing dirty or immoral about sex, Mr. Gupta.
Nothing dirty? Displaying half-naked women in store and website might be fine for you Kabaddiyas, not for us.
Maybe. But as I understand it, you Cricketiyas have sex too, right? Lingerie just makes the sex a little more interesting. It's a loving gift from a woman to her man.
Nonsense.
Or you could just lie there on your back and wait for it to get over, which is probably what you've done your whole life.
What did you say? Say it again, you whore!
Mommy! Hey, you're a guest.
Stop. Enough. We've been insulted enough already. If it wasn't for Chubby, we would have left a long time.
Auntie,
sorry, beta. Let's go finish.
All right, Jaja, chal, get out, hoja! You think they'll give our daughter to you? I am never. For 4 years, you have used your evil influence on her. This is what you people do, don't you? Using your influence on our daughters. I mean, Chubby will never marry your son. Do you hear me?
Some guts that woman has to come in my house.
La.
You planned everything, didn't you? Everything was planned. To call them home, feed them food, and then insult them so much that they just leave.
Chubby, it was for your own good.
Just shut up!
How dare you!
Hilda!
You want to bring disgrace to your family?
Huh?
You want to marry that boy and sell underwear?
Stop it!
Is that what you want to do?
Hilda, that's
it. If it was up to me, I would lock her up in a room till she came to her senses.
Hilda!
Huh?
Let her come.
Why did you do it, Papa? Why?
What were you thinking, beta? Would we have let you marry a Kabaddiya? I've devoted my entire life protecting our sport faith. And to have my own daughter marry outside the community? And that to a reformist sport faith? These people are the enemies of cricket. Traitors to this country. Forget him! Suna!
Smoothie?
Yeah.
No calls?
No.
Acha?
She texted, but I haven't replied.
Why?
What?
Why haven't you replied?
I don't know. I guess I haven't recovered from last evening.
Last evening was premeditated. You know that, right? If that's how they felt about us all along, they would have never invited us home. Their plan was to ambush us, insult us, and drive a wedge between you and Chubby.
Chubby had no idea.
Of course she didn't. The poor girl deserves better parents.
She's very close to them.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know.
Beta. Think hard before you take your next step. I know the two of you have been going out for a couple of years now, but sometimes things just aren't meant to be.
You've always said the opposite, that we are made for each other.
I understand, Beta, but at what cost? You might be together, but her family will disown her. She'll never be happy.
You don't know that. They may come around. We can convince them.
Even then, their ways are very different from ours. Will you be able to adjust? Will she?
Kabaddiyas aren't that ritualistic anyways, and we are even less so.
She's been brought up in the Cricketiya tradition. Any way you look at it, the marriage will be an adjustment for both of you.
These customs, traditions, adjusting, these aren't big things. I can do anything for her and she for me. We've always said this to each other over and over again.
Young love, so beautiful, so optimistic.
You're mocking me.
Of course not, Beta. Can I mock you? Huh? My precious darling boy. Just want you to be happy. So what are you going to do?
I don't know. I don't know.
So you're just going to sit there?
Then what do I do?
Call her.
Call her? She's at home.
Okay, then text her. How many texts has she sent you?
I don't know. Maybe 20.
20?
Maybe more.
Since when?
Since last night.
And she got nothing back from you?
Her parents insulted you, me, our way of life. I'm entitled to serve a little longer.
Achoo. So that girl is dying over there out of shame and guilt and fear and God knows what else. And you think it's okay to sit here and sulk?
Well, she sulks. She's the queen of sulking. Whenever I do something to hurt her, she won't reply to my text for 2 days sometimes.
She's a woman. Do I have to explain everything to you? Give me that phone.
Wait, why?
So that I can text
her. No, thanks. No.
Fine, then text her yourself, you idiot.
Fine.
So what did you say?
Let's talk.
Let's talk.
let's talk, darling.
Yeah. Oh, Emma, please. No, no, I'm not. Emma, this is my end. Okay, please.
Okay, fine. Go answer the door.
Chameli!
She's gone to the market. Go. Just like his father.
Mom.
Who was it, beta?
Mom.
Who was it? Pradeep, reduce the volume. Pradeep!
Huh?
It's too loud.
Oh, sorry.
What are you watching anyway? Far as I know, there's no game today.
Thursday's replay. It was a close game. Very exciting.
But you already know who won.
Yes, Dabang Delhi. I won't be watching it otherwise.
What's the fun in watching a game if you know who won?
I can't watch live games anymore. Too much excitement. And then if we lose, I'm depressed for the whole day.
Are you happy now?
What?
Are you happy now?
Yes.
Good. So what's next? Have you thought about the future?
The future?
Mm-hmm.
Have I thought about the future? Well, if I did everything around here, then what will you do, right?
Such
huh?
A brat.
Wow.
Hi.
Hey! Feeling better?
Yeah. Slept okay, Bitter?
Yes, Auntie. How long was I out?
5 hours.
5 hours?
It's okay. You needed the rest. You haven't slept all night. Can I get you some tea?
I'll make it.
No, sit. I'll get it.
Thank you, Auntie.
But you like your tea boiled, right? With milk and sugar?
No, Auntie. Black tea is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes, Auntie. Black tea is fine.
Okay, sorry. I just forgot.
Achcha! Black is fine. When you're with me, you won't even touch black tea. Gee, it's a bitter. How can you drink this? But with mom? Yes, Auntie. Black is fine.
So why don't you offer to make it for me, huh?
Sorry, but I can't make your kadak chai with malai floating on top and all. Yuck.
You can't even do that much for your soulmate.
Even if I wanted to, I couldn't make it the way you like it. We don't keep buffalo milk at home.
At all?
No. Sorry.
Cha. Okay.
Mom was right. You won't be able to adjust.
What? Impossible. Auntie would never say that about me.
Yes, she did. Ask him yourself.
Ask me what?
Nothing. Auntie is up to his usual antics.
Ready. Stop bothering her.
Alright, what did I do?
Now stop pacing over there and come sit down.
Alright.
Not there. Here.
No. I'm fine over here.
Freddy, come and sit next to Chavi.
But she kicks!
What? Will you ever be serious? Come.
Okay, fine. Since you're requesting me.
Thank you. So, we have some serious things we need to talk about.
Uh-oh, that's a serious business tone.
Chavi, beta, you can't stay here with us.
What? Mom, what are you saying? Where will she go?
Don't worry, your mother's thought about all that. She'll stay at the company guest house.
Guest house?
Mm-hmm. It has a fully furnished service department in a GK2 gated community. It's secure, it's well located, it's really nice. There's a caretaker who comes twice a day. He'll take care of everything, the cooking, the cleaning. You'll be really comfortable.
Why can't she just stay here?
For her own good. If her family finds out she's here, they'll assume the worst and they'll never forgive her.
But that doesn't mean that, like,
and,
I just...
And I'm not that liberal.
Auntie, if you think that's for the best, I can stay at the guest house. I don't have any problem.
Thank you, baby. Your college is really close to there. I assume you'll continue with that?
Absolutely.
Wonderful.
Well, I'll be at work during the day, of course. But I'll stop by in the evenings, just to make sure you're comfortable.
About that, Pradeep, you won't be going to the guest house.
What?
You can meet anywhere you'd like, and as often as you'd like. Here, outside, just not at the guest house.
How is that okay, Mom?
Pitta, I don't know what you guys were up to before this, and honestly, I don't want to know. But right now, I'm like her guardian. She's my responsibility.
Yes, Auntie, I promise. Pradeep won't come to the guest house.
Thanks.
Oh, God.
I trust you about this far more than I trust him. When he's around you, he loses half his IQ points.
That still makes me a genius.
Which brings me to the last and most important matter. What next? You two obviously can't go on like this.
Exactly. How long do I not have visitation rights?
Chavi.
Auntie, I haven't thought about the future. Yesterday was horrible. All I could think of was that I couldn't possibly go on living there after my parents insulted you and tried to ruin my relationship. And when Pradeep won't reply to
I'm
my
I'm so
text,
sorry, sweetheart. I'm such a fool.
No, it's okay. I understand. I don't blame you. I'm really grateful that you took me in, Auntie.
Hey,
come on.
Stop crying.
Hey.
You were saying something, Auntie?
Yes. I think that you two should get married.
What?
But only with the blessings of your parents. So if you truly love my son, pour your heart and soul into convincing them.
Ah, Deepak.
Ah, Papa, you're back.
Where's Mummy?
She went to the market. She made a cup of tea for you. Can I get you anything else, Papa?
No.
Papa, can I talk to you about something?
Of course. Back from the market?
Deepak, did you give Papa the cup of tea?
Yes, Mommy.
Are wa? And some namkeen too?
Any news?
No.
Papa?
Yes, beta, what did you want to talk about?
Well, the other day you asked me what I wanted to do.
When?
Are on Sunday when we were having breakfast?
Oh, But I thought you said you didn't know what you wanted.
Well, actually I do.
Why didn't you say so?
I wasn't ready to tell you.
And now you're ready?
Yes, Papa. I want to be a school teacher.
A school teacher? In what subject? They don't teach philosophy in schools, you know.
I teach social studies.
History, geography, civics?
Yes, Papa, and if school allows, I'll offer optional classes on philosophy to high school students.
Beta, a school teacher doesn't make a whole lot of money, you know that, right?
I know, Papa.
How are you going to live? The rents in Delhi even for one room are so high.
And he'll stay with us.
For how long? Eventually he'll get married, he'll have children.
I have no such plans.
Are, we have three rooms, we will adjust. Let him do know what he wants.
Where are you planning to teach?
St. Mary's Convent.
ICSE.
CBSE or Delhi Board School will not let me offer philosophy classes.
What is this, Deepak? You'll be teaching history. At least teach it from the right textbooks.
Why?
Mummy.
What's wrong with their history textbooks?
Mummy, see, ICSE textbooks are not Vibha approved.
Of course not. They're full of lies. Anti-cricket propaganda. They make cricket look like a foreign sport.
But some people say cricket did come from England.
Arre, no. Where are you reading all this, huh? Wooden bats have been used by Indians to wash clothes for ages. Even now in some parts. That same bat with cloth balls was used in a very popular game in India that later became cricket. Vasco da Gama took it to Europe. It was then refined in England in the 18th century to what we now know as modern day cricket. Please pick up a CBSE history textbook and read.
Okay, Papa.
Arre, so he'll teach whatever is there in their textbook. It's okay. At least they are letting him teach a course of his interest and they are giving him higher salary. Arre, he'll always remain a devout cricketer. He's our son after all.
Seems like the two of you already talked about this.
Let him do know what he wants.
Papa?
Okay.
Thank you, Papa. I'll go and fill out the application forms now.
See how excited he is. I have not seen him so happy in 2 years.
I just wish this excitement was for something more respectable.
It's okay. He'll make less money, but he'll be at home.
It's not about the money, Bimla. I haven't made a whole lot of money myself. I have respect.
Kya kar sakte? We can't force our children to do something we want them to, can we?
So, no news?
No.
It's been 3 days. She should at least let us know that she's okay.
You're concerned?
Shouldn't I be?
I didn't say that.
Aren't you concerned? Granted, she's gone to somebody else's house.
So? Does that make it okay? A daughter is in someone's house with a boy she is not married to and you're okay with that?
They are not alone there. The boy's mother is also there.
Are you trust that Kamini? By now she probably has Chavi modeling for her underwears.
Teach? Chee chee.
And in another week's time, your daughter's pictures will be on her website for everyone to see.
Do you even listen to what you're saying?
Yes, I do. It's you who can't face the truth that your daughter has run off with a Kabaddiya. And what have you done about it so far? Nothing. The only thing you have done in last 3 days is express concern.
What do you want me to do? I'm worried about her.
But is she worried about us? Has she thought about what we are going through? No, she hasn't. That's why we don't know where she is. Except for those 2 lines she wrote in that letter she left behind. Going to Pradeep's house, won't be coming back. It's like someone had slapped me.
So strange. So unlike her. Fine, she was, she had reason to be upset that day, but it's been 3 days now. Not even a text. It's so irresponsible.
You know who's behind all this, right? That witch. She is the one influencing Chavi. Of course, Chavi is to be blamed too. She's given enough opportunity. Going to their house twice for lunch and dinner for years. Now that Kamini auntie has become like a second mother to her. Sophisticated, rich second mother.
Sir, did you try to contact her?
I sent her a text.
When? You never told me.
She didn't reply.
What did you say in the text?
I had made her favorite bundi raita yesterday. Sent her a photo.
Oh, oh. Arey, baskar ab ro mat. Arey, it's okay. Don't worry, it's not so bad. We'll fix it. Rona bank kar. Now stop crying, okay? You know what? Enough is enough. I'm just going to go bring her.
What?
I've taken her address anywhere.
Over my dead body.
What? Why?
Don't you dare go there, otherwise you will not find me here when you get back.
What's your problem?
Hey, just think for a change. What are you going to say to her when she opens the door for you?
I'll just say pack your bags and leave.
Oh, for not Chavi, that Kamini. What are you going to say to her? Are you going to beg to her? Madam, please can I take my daughter home? She is the one responsible for all this. That Andi, Randi has corrupted her. Otherwise, Chavi would have never left home.
No, not Chavi, is not so naive.
Cricketiya girl away from her family, it must be like getting a ticket to Kabaddi heaven.
Chavi is not so naive.
Achcha. So how do you explain everything that's going on? Before this, has there ever been a day when you didn't know where your daughter was?
Before this, something like this has never happened.
So we shouldn't have done what we did. We should have just handed over our daughter to that chal Kabaddi family. That's what you're saying?
No, that's not what I'm saying.
And when will you wake up? When you get an invitation for your own daughter's wedding?
Calm down, Binda. You're just imagining.
Calm down? Our daughter is in that Kabaddiya's home and you are asking me to calm down? I feel like my head is going to explode.
Maybe you're right. One day I can understand. 3 days is too much. We need to do something. Force their hand.
Finally.
What should we do? Last time too, it was your idea.
Are you sure you want to hear it?
Yes.
You won't dismiss it immediately?
No, I won't.
Burn her underwear store to the ground.
What?
Displaying half-naked women in store and website. Our culture doesn't permit such things.
Hmm.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, yes, I understand very well.
Then what was that hmm for? Just last week you sent your Cricketiya boys to the hockey finals, didn't you?
That was different, Bimla. It was for the party, orders from above.
So you'll do it for the party, but not for your own daughter?
This is a personal matter, Bimla.
Then don't ask me for ideas.
Bimla, this is wrong. If they find out, I could be brought up for disciplinary action.
No one will say anything if they understand the circumstances. A Kabaddiya boy runs away with a daughter of a prominent Cricketiya family. Are they going to be okay with that?
Not a politician, not a public figure.
You are an important person in the party. And you'll become more prominent soon. Once your promotion comes through, you will be on TV representing the party. I want to see you on TV.
That will take time.
It'll happen if all goes well. But if the word gets out that your daughter married a Kabaddiya, your career is over and you know it.
Hmm.
Papa, Mummy, Chavi just texted me.
Read,
what did she say?
Hi, Bhia. I'm all right. Staying at Pradeep's mom's company's guest house.
Thank God she's okay.
Then it's a nice flat in GK2 with a caretaker who takes care of everything here, cooking, cleaning, etc.
At least Kamini has some sense. She's put up Chavi in a separate place.
Come on, Mummy.
Abhe, chup kar. Aage pad.
I've started going to college again today. It's a short ride in an auto from here. I'm okay, but I miss you all. Mummy, Papa, are they very upset?
Anything else?
That's it.
What did you say to her?
I just sent her one text. Hi, how are you?
That's it? Your sister has been gone for 3 days. We have no idea how she is. She finally decides to send a text, not to me, not to your father, but to you, and that's all you could say to her?
If I had texted her, you would have scolded me. Why did you say this? Why didn't you say that? It's better to text nothing.
Excuses! Whenever there is something difficult, you choose to do nothing, just like your father.
Excuse me?
What is she doing for food? Ask her.
She said there is a caretaker in the apartment.
Are, but does he cook and what does he cook?
Okay, I'll ask. Mummy wants to know.
Are, why can't you ask her the question?
Because I'm her brother.
So you can't ask her as a brother?
I have never ever wondered what she was eating.
Deepak,
stop bickering, both of you. Where did she say her guest house was?
GK2.
Ask her for the address.
Just like that.
Just like what? You want me to dictate the question to you?
Shouldn't we say something else for showing some sympathy, some relief?
Okay. Express your sympathy and relief.
What are you going to do with the address?
Let's see if she gives it to us.
She won't.
Let's see. What did you say?
Hi, happy you're okay, was worried sick. She replied, I know you would be. I'm sorry, how are mummy and papa?
Tell her mummy and papa are doing fine. They're enjoying themselves.
Don't listen to her. Just say it. They want you to come back, they are worried about you.
And fall flat at their feet and beg for forgiveness, only then they will let you in the house.
Said?
Yes, and she replied, no, I can't, not after what happened.
What did I tell you?
Ask her for the address.
Done. She's typing. It's 152 Sector 8 GK2.
Got it.
What's the plan?
Plan? Quite simple, really. You will go there and bring her back.
Are, why should I?
She's your daughter.
Atta, she's your daughter too.
Your persuasive powers are much greater than mine.
Hey, nonsense.
I have personal experience.
Fine. I will try my best. But what if she refuses to come home with me?
We'll cross the bridge when we come to it.
If words are not enough, action becomes necessary.
Yeah, sure.
Do you understand what I'm saying? If action becomes necessary, you won't back off, right?
Yes. You focus on what you're going to tell Chavi when you see her. If she doesn't come back, I'll then do what needs to be done.
Sure.
Yes, sure. Deepak, you take your mummy to that address this evening.
Okay, Papa.
Mummy, bhaiya, come here. Look.
Wow, what a view.
This is my favorite spot in the guest house. Must be a lot of work to clean this glass.
Yeah, especially in Delhi's pollution.
They have cleaning service.
Not the caretaker.
He supervises them.
So, you have servants who manage other servants?
Ranjira comes in the morning. Makes breakfast, does all the household chores, and then he leaves. When I come back in the evening, he also comes back.
Nice.
So where is this caterer?
Caretaker, mummy.
That only I said.
I let him go a little early today. Generally, he serves me dinner and then only leaves.
Serves me dinner? Sounds very nice. I wish someone was serving me dinner at least once in a while. You must be getting used to all this nice flat, people serving you dinner.
It's been just 4 days, mummy. Shorter than our holiday to Mussoorie last year.
When is this GK2 holiday of yours coming to end?
How's Papa?
He's fine.
Well, he was worried about you actually. He brought on his acid reflux.
Oh.
He was better today. Once he heard that you were okay, it just disappeared.
He was relieved that you're not living with this Kabaddiya.
Pradeep is a very nice boy, mummy. You would really like him if you got to know
he
him.
He is a Kabaddiya and that's enough for me.
Please give him a chance. Please give them a chance. Kamini auntie is also very nice.
Hare, who am I to give them a chance or not? They mean nothing to me. Never have and never will. And this Kamini auntie of yours, she's a big show-off. With all that hairstyle and fashion left over from the British Raj.
Come on, mummy.
What?
You have met them just once.
And once is enough. I'm not afraid to say what I feel. Why should I be? I'm not ashamed of anything.
They are different from us, but that doesn't make them bad.
I didn't say they are good or bad. They're just not our people and they don't matter to us. And as long as they leave our daughters alone, there should be no trouble.
Right, and our jobs.
Yes, that too.
And our neighborhood, isn't it?
Why am I explaining myself? Chavi? Actually, you are the one who should be giving the explanation. You left your home, your family. For 3 days, we didn't hear from you. Actually, I'm very angry with you. But if you accept your mistake and come home with us, we'll forget everything that has happened. You hear me? Okay, come on, let's go home. Come on, let's go home. Stop crying.
Mommy, I want to marry Pradhan.
What?
Please, mommy.
Are you crazy?
Please, mommy.
Over my dead body, you're not marrying that Kabaddiya.
Let's go home, Chavi. We can talk there.
Yes, let's go home. But there will be no talk, no discussion about this. Is that clear? And no more going to the mall to meet boys. You told us you were not ready for marriage. You think your father is going to be okay with all this? He's at a senior post in the party.
Yes, but I'm his daughter and I want to marry the man I love. Does he love his status more than me?
A man I love? Wow. You've gotten too much freedom in college. Not anymore. Suna? Oye! Samjha ise!
Chavi, have you thought this through? How will it work? Their ways are completely different than ours.
They're not so different, and even if they were, we will make it work. We'll adjust, we'll compromise.
Will you be accepted by their friends and family? Will your family accept him? Or will you have to choose between him or your family? Love isn't enough to live on, you know.
That's why I'm trying to convince them. No. Mommy, please.
All this talk about love and marriage, let me tell you how it works. First, you marry a devout cricketer, yeah? Then you learn to love him. Understand? Let's go home.
No.
Shabe?
No.
What?
I will marry Pradhan.
So now this Kabaddiya matters more than your own family.
The same family who tried to deceive me, betray me, and tried to ruin my relationship with Pradhan by deliberately calling them home and insulting them.
Deepak, let's go.
Wait a minute. All she's saying is, she just wants to talk. Can't you hold out the possibility of marriage?
No. No, Pradeep. No talk. Those are my conditions.
You are putting conditions on her after what you did.
Deepak, I'm going downstairs. I'm calling an auto and I'm going home.
Bhaiya, please talk to her.
You know her, Chavi.
If she comes around, I know Papa will too.
I don't think they will. Not about this.
You please try, Bhaiya.
I have to go now, Chavi. Take care of yourself.
Please, Bhaiya.
This place is fine. There you go. What is it back, sir? You're carrying it on, must be something important. I'll tell you later. Have you ever smoked a cigarette?
Nice, sir. Cigarette itself new for me. I learned this smoking only after coming to Delhi.
I'll get some beers for us one of these days. It has quite a kick. Very different from a cigarette.
Acha?
In our village, any time of the day you go to, you'll find at least half a dozen men sitting at the village square smoking away beers. That is the village social media.
Sanji, you were telling you wanted to ask me about something important.
What is the rush? Let us enjoy the cigarette first.
No, sir. I was in middle of writing report for Gupta, sir. It was a bit complex, so stress was.
For Gupta. Okay, then. Let's get started. Ready? Last night at Gupta, sir, he called. He said, Samshir, I have an important job for you. Confidential. Don't tell anyone. So I thought it might be some party work. Sometimes orders always come from there. So I said, yes, sir, give me the order.
What was the job, sir?
Well, I asked him. So he said that there is a shop that is inciting to our culture. The shop has to be attacked and then burned to ground.
Outbreak? You? What is so inciting?
The shop and its website has photos of half-naked Indian women.
Oh!
By then I of course knew what shop he was talking about.
Sunnyvale Pradhan.
Correct.
You see, that angry at the Pradeep Sharma, but he would burn down his issue. Huh? What mistake did he do, sir? Just friend to be shorter, huh?
Boyfriend?
Still, sir.
A Kabaddiya has done the daring of having a love affair with the daughter of a Cricketiya Bhat.
Oh, doesn't mean he can do anything to him.
For Gupta it does.
Which is wrong, sir. Very wrong.
Also, how that this is personal matter.
Yeah, that is true.
So now, you will burn the sword down.
First, go and get something. Then I'll explain. Get it quickly, Jyoti.
You'll burn the sword?
What do you think? I can get it done quite easily. 10 years full of unemployed young men who are waiting for a chance like this. For them, burning down a store is the best entertainment. And they know that the police will not get involved because it's party work. So should I get it done?
You say no, you lose job, nah.
And you don't worry about that. You tell me what you really think. Didn't you once say that violence for politics is bad for the country?
Huh, I did.
So now you changed.
How you can disobey orders, sir?
I disobeyed already.
You said no?
Yes, I said no.
Sanjeev, what are you saying? Gupta sir will terminate your...
He won't. Not at least now. He knows if he does, I will expose him.
I did not think of that.
But what I am about to do now, after that he will definitely fire me.
Meaning? What are you planning to do?
When I first refused his order, he got very angry with me. Threatened me with all kinds of things, not just firing. I stayed quiet, but I did not change my stance either. In the end he said, Shamshir, I don't even need you, I do it myself.
Guptaji will get it done himself?
Yeah, he can. When the SD cell started, Gupta used to manage social media. He knows what to do.
Achcha, at least you won't be involved.
Actually, I will be involved. Because I am going to save Shanaya Bador.
What?
Look, Jyoti, I am a jat. Once I make up my mind, I am very stubborn. I am going to save Shanaya Bador from Gupta's gundas.
But how, sir? You are single person and they will be in gang.
So what? I have some plan.
I'm coming with you, sir.
Arey, no, this is not for you.
Why not? If you can take a stand, I can take a stand.
Don't be stupid, you've just gotten your job.
I don't want to work for such people, sir.
Sure.
Sure.
Think it over.
Sir, got it over, confirm.
Okay then, partner, let's do it.
Can I ask something, sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
You won't mistake.
No, now we are partners. Go ahead.
You're doing all this because you like Shavi Gupta, right?
Maybe.
I understand, sir.
Look, Jyoti. Chavi is a really nice girl. She's always spoken well to me. Never like an employee of her father.
How do you know her?
From the interdepartmental cricket tournaments.
I've heard you're a solid batsman and every time we win because of you.
After winning the match, I used to go up to the VIP stand and do my pranam to Guptaji. Chavi would be there too. She would congratulate me, we would talk for a bit. She always spoke so nicely. I can't stand by and let her get hurt. I'll save her, even if from her own father.
Achha, Sanaya Bador has 3 Swapna. Which one are they going to attack? Did you get that information from Gupta? Otherwise, how do we know?
The South X one. I might be a giant, but I'm not that foolish.
That reminds me of a saying.
Achha, go ahead.
Jaat re jaat, sola duniyat.
Sale? Don't forget, I'm still your manager.
Just 1 or 2 more days, sir. After that, both of us, unemployed.
That is also correct. So, what will you do after this?
Me? I will go back to Patna and start social media marketing agency.
What?
Meaning, Patna has many small trade business. Shop, agency, all these people know how to use Facebook, WhatsApp, but don't understand how to use for marketing.
Oh.
So I will advise them on how to use social media for their business.
Good idea.
Ora, what are you planning to do?
Nothing. I just want to go back to my village and smoke BDs for a few months. After that, I'll think what to do next.
That is also a good idea. So what is plan, sir?
Plan. Okay. So, get up. You're asking me, right? What is in the bag? Try this.
What is it, sir?
Arre, just try it, yaar. These are Delhi police uniforms.
We are joining Delhi police.
Fake police, Jyoti. We will go to Sarai Madhora as fake police.
Achha, and then?
And then we will save the shop from Gupta's Gundas. Okay?
Sure.
Okay, let's go there.
1 minute, sir. We'll come back.
Yeah. I have been monitoring our live ads and social media accounts. From that, we will know when they are going to attack the shop. Okay, put this on. Let's go.
But sir, you already had my uniform? Meaning, you knew I would join you?
Of course. I am still your guru.
Even a little foolish.
Yes, Pradeep ji, definitely a little foolish.
I mean, there was just the two of you. What if they hadn't backed down? It's not like you guys had guns or anything.
Can you help me, please? Just pull that forward.
These Gunda types are actually cowards, Pradeep ji. In such matters, they don't encounter the police because the SD cell takes care of it. So that's why we thought that if we showed up as the police, we could surprise these Gundas long enough, take away their bats and wickets and send them off.
Please sit.
Thank you.
But we knew that police uniform might not be enough, so we had a backup plan. Make a fake call and pretend that large police force is on its way.
And the fake call worked. Brilliant idea, Jyoti.
What acting you did, sir, on phone, huh? Gundas got scared. Just ran.
Unbelievable. So you saved me and you saved the shop.
Yeah, but we wish we could have saved you from that.
Oh, this is nothing. If it had been for you both, Gupta's Gundas would have sent me to the hospital on a stretcher.
There's one thing, when you showed up at the back of the shop, you surprised not just the Gundas, but us also.
See, Mom, I was back at the storeroom, blissfully unaware of what was happening. I enter and I see this shady looking character, not like our usual lingerie customer, stripping the merchandise of the mannequin. I went wild, I just rushed towards him. And then, of course, the shady's friend joined the fight, and these guys came out trying to stop them. And in all that pushing and shoving, I fell against the corner of the counter and then this happened. That's all.
Thank you.
Arey Kamini ji, we just did what was right.
You comfortable?
Yeah, Mom, I'm fine. Thanks.
Okay, I'll go make you something to eat.
No, Mom, I'm not hungry.
Have something, my beta. Some soup or something.
Mom, I'm fine, really. You can stop fussing.
You're hurt.
It's just a scratch.
Just a scratch? You got 6 stitches. I can't take the stress anymore, do you understand me? The 30 minutes that it took for you to get here were just unbearable. Waiting, worrying, afraid something really bad had happened to you.
We told you on the phone that
all happened. But how was I to know? You could have been lying to spare me the agony.
But we weren't lying, it's just a scratch.
How was I to know? Why is it so difficult for you to understand? And this thing that you're calling a scratch, when I opened that car door, there was blood everywhere. On your clothes, on their clothes. sorry. It's just the shock of seeing him like this. I'm not usually this way. Really sorry.
It's okay, madam. We understand.
But madam, Pradeep ji is right. Injury was not that serious, thank God. It could have been a lot worse. Broken bones, ribs, cracked skull. Huh? After all, they'd come with bats and wickets. He is lucky, actually.
He talks too much.
Can I get you some tea?
No, nothing. Thank you.
Have something, no?
Some water would be nice.
Sure.
Oh, mom, Chavi hasn't come. Did you call her?
God, beta, with all this going on, I just completely forgot.
How could you, mom? Now she's going to be so upset.
At least she didn't have to suffer what I went through. You should probably just tell her to come over. Don't tell her you're injured.
Yeah, good idea. Hi! How was the viva? Oh, wow. Hey, you want to come over? Yes, now. Well, you can have dessert here. Yes, mom is here. I'm not going to take advantage of you. Thank you. Huh. I'll see you soon. Women, always suspicious. I mean, if they're suspicious about your motives for everything, then chances are they will be right some of the time, no? And those few times are then declared as evidence of the female intuition, which then, of course, gives them the license to continue to suspect our motives at all times. Right? Correct, no?
Nonsense. Suspicions are like hypotheses in science. Women have more of them and we like to test them, and that makes us more scientific.
Wow, mom. Fantastic logic.
Where are you two from? You don't look like you're Delhiites.
I am from Haryana.
I am from Bihar, madam.
Can I ask you something? This self-defense cell of yours, you have this kind of power to carry out something like this?
Social media is very powerful, madam. In the right hands, with trained people like us, backing of the government, it can do almost anything.
Hmm. Did Gupta know that Pradeep was going to be at the shop?
I don't think so, otherwise he would have told me.
Maybe he knew and he didn't want to tell you?
I mean, he told me everything else, and Pradeep being there was an important point.
Gundas were there to damage shop, madam. They were not looking for Pradeep.
So, Gupta asks you to do this live action. You said no, and then you decided to stop him.
Yes.
And you decided to join him at great personal risk to yourself. I mean, anything could have happened at the shop.
Ji, madam, ji.
Why?
We might be Cricketiyas, madam. But we are not this bad that we will destroy somebody's life for personal reasons like this.
Also, he knows Chavi.
Really?
Just a little bit. From the interdepartmental tournament, where she comes with her father. She's a nice girl.
That she is.
And why did you get involved?
Madam, if my guru was going to fight for what is right, I was not going to be a coward.
Well, whatever your reasons. If it weren't for you both, then Pradeep would have definitely fought with those men, and God knows what could have happened. The damage could have been a lot worse than just what happened to the shop. I am so, so grateful to both of you. I mean, it was so brave what you did, and to do this for someone you don't even know, I don't know what to say.
Thanks, guys. Really.
No mention, Pradeep ji. Someone has to stand up for what is right.
And in this job of mine, I've done a lot of things that I'm not proud of. But this man here, my trainee, he made me realize what I had become.
Nahi, sir. What are you saying?
Saying right, Jyoti. Even if Gupta doesn't terminate me, I'll resign.
Me too, madam.
This is so wrong. You did something so noble and you risked your lives, and on top of that, you're losing your jobs. Tell me, what can I do to help you both?
You don't need to do anything, Kabaddi ji.
No, you must let me help you. You're losing your jobs because of what you did for us.
No, madam. We had decided to quit anyway. We don't want to work for people like Gupta.
Yes, but what are your future plans? Can I help in any way?
Oh, future plan? Both are future plan? Pakka, madam. I am going to go back to Patna to start social media marketing agency. And he is going back to his village, Thelanwali, to smoke bidis.
Are you
sure I can't help in any way?
It's not needed, Kamini ji. And we did not do any of this for personal gain. We just did what we felt was right.
I understand.
I think we should get going now. Thank you.
Shamshir, can you please just write down your mobile numbers here for me?
Yes.
Hello, huh? Where are you? Come fast, no? Yeah, cool. Okay, huh, sorry. Okay, bye.
Get well soon, Pradeep ji.
Thanks, guys. Stay safe. Something on your mind?
What happened today changes everything.
What do you mean?
We'll talk about it later. Right now, you need to get upstairs and get some rest.
Come. No, but Chavi's coming.
It's okay. She can sit with you in her room. Come. How far is she?
2 minutes.
All right. Careful. Slow. Yeah. Put your arm. Now, here's the deal, all right? When she gets here, you're going to want to tell her everything, and she's going to want to fuss over you. But need you to rest, all right? So you get half an hour, and after that, you're going to bed. Understood?
Fine, Mom.
Don't say fine. Say you promise.
I promise.
Did he fall asleep?
Asleep within seconds of hitting the bed.
Stressful day, painkillers. Thank you for forcing him to rest. Can I get you more tea?
I haven't finished my first cup yet, Auntie.
I can make you a fresh one.
No, thanks.
So, how are you feeling?
Well, the man I love was beaten up by gundas. The bidding of my own father. How should I be feeling, Auntie?
Could have been a lot worse if Shamshir and Jyoti hadn't been there.
Did Papa... Was Pradeep the target or was it the shop and Pradeep just happened to be there?
I think Pradeep was the target.
But how did he... they know that Pradeep was going to be there at the Southix Mall shop.
Maybe they were watching the shop and they attacked when they knew he'd be there?
No, Auntie, I don't think the gundas work with that much of planning.
Maybe your father knew.
But then why attack him in the shop? They could have done it outside somewhere, in the parking lot or something. And why did they start pulling down all the merchandise and the mannequins?
Maybe they were told to attack both him and the shop. After all, it is his shop. Did you think he was capable of something like this? Neither did I. In spite of all the things they said to me at your house the other day, never thought your father would go this far, otherwise I would have sent you back home.
Who does this? This barbarism? How many times he would be reading the morning newspaper and mocking other countries for treating their women like cattle. And now, he's doing it to his own daughter.
The high priests of hate, those who would divide us, the thing they fear the most is intermarriage, because it makes the divisions go away, dilutes the hatred, reduces their power. But this, what happened to Pradeep today, there's a ruthlessness here that even I couldn't have imagined. How can you hate someone so intensely when you don't even know them?
I'm so ashamed. So, so full of shame.
It's not your fault.
It is my fault. If I hadn't left home, if I had stayed back and tried to convince them, none of this would have happened.
Do you think you would have been able to convince them?
I could have tried, but I didn't, and look what happened.
It's not your fault.
My fault is this, that I was born to such parents. Auntie, you have been very kind to me. In another life, I would have been so lucky to be your bahu. But I can't let this happen again. If he gets hurt again, he will just kill me. Maybe I need to walk away. Maybe I need to leave Pradeep.
I think that might be for the best.
You won't even try to convince me to stay?
Do you want me to?
I don't know. I love him a lot. And I can't let him get hurt because of me.
Sometimes things just aren't meant to be.
We always said just the opposite. That we were meant to be together. That nothing could keep us apart.
But you wouldn't be happy together.
Yes, but we would be together.
What kind of life would it be? Your family would disown you. You'd constantly fear for the safety of the man you love. Is that what you want?
We ever stand the chance?
The odds were against you. We knew that. But what you and I didn't anticipate is the extent to which your father would go to prevent this marriage from happening.
Can we run away somewhere far off? No one would know where we are.
You'd lose your family, your friends, both of you.
Yes, but we'll be together.
I am not losing Pradeep. He stays here, and he stays safe.
What are you going to tell him?
The truth. You loved him so much that you left him. But you have to make a clean break, Chavi. Block all his calls, texts, voicemails. Stay away from social media, disconnect completely. There's one more thing. Tomorrow morning, he'll come looking for you at the guest house, first thing in the morning. You have to leave that place. Where will you go?
I don't know. The thought of going back home makes me sick.
You could stay at a hotel for a bit. I can take care of the bill.
No, thank you.
Then?
I don't know, Auntie. I haven't really thought about it. Maybe I'll go to her friend's place. Maybe I'll call Shamshir. Why not? He seems to have a soft corner for me. And he's a Cricketiya. Can I say bye to him?
Chavi, please.
Yeah, I know. It's not right.
Write him a letter. Send it by post later.
One last look. Please.
Shamshir, this is Kamini. You have the number of someone I'm looking for? Adipak Gupta?
Thank you for calling, bhaiya, and for coming so quickly.
When I heard you crying on the phone, I had to. What happened? Are you okay?
It's okay. Everything will be alright.
Didn't you close the door? I told you not to tell anyone. I told you to come along.
Chavi, I did it for you. It can't go on like this.
Chavi, just please leave from here. Please leave.
I didn't know he would be there. He's always at that Connaught Place shop.
lies. All lies. I don't believe you. I will never believe you.
I didn't mean to hurt him. When Deepak told me, I was very sad and worried about you.
The only thing that you worry about is your standing among the Cricketiyas. How they would mock you if your daughter ran away with the Kabaddiya. That's what you worry about. You don't worry about me.
No, Chavi. He was very depressed. He hasn't eaten anything.
You shut up, you traitor.
Come on, Chavi. That's not fair.
Don't blame your father, Chavi. I made him do it. I was very angry, but I never wanted to hurt him.
You both, my own parents, you ruined my life. I'm so ashamed of being your daughter.
Don't talk like that, Chavi.
What's done is done. I wish I could undo it, but I cannot.
Yeah, a lot is done. I left Pradeep. You won.
It's not about winning or losing, Chavi.
Do you know why I left him? Because I was afraid what my monster of a father would do to him next.
What are you saying, Chavi?
I will never forgive both of you.
Hey, beta.
Just please leave.
We are not your enemy. We are your parents. We want you to be happy. We have a responsibility towards you. We also carry a responsibility towards your children and their children. Marriage is the tradition that carries tradition, culture, and dharma forward through the generations. You know what's the most important decision a man makes in his life? Who he gives his daughter away to and who he accepts as Bahu. There's a responsibility that's been handed down to me from my father and his. I do not take this responsibility lightly. It's my dharma. And yes, it is my decision, not yours. You don't have the wisdom that my age gives me. You're young and easily swayed by good looks and sweet words. Only we, your parents, can decide if a man is suitable to be the father of your children. Our ways must be preserved. My ancestors demand it. Sacred sport of cricket demands. And for that to happen, your husband must be a devout Cricketiya, unswerving in his faith and in his commitment to transmit his faith to your children.
We only want what's best for you, Chavi. I know you don't believe us. I know you think you're going to be happy with this Kabaddiya. But your father and I, we have seen enough of this life to know how hard it will be for you to adjust if you marry outside the community. They are non-vegetarians, beta. What will you do? Cook meat for him? Use separate bartans? How will you do your puja? Where will you keep your gods? What sport faith will your children follow? You won't be able to do it, Chavi, if you want to remain a Cricketiya. And I know you will never want to convert.
Mummy, she's not listening to you.
Chavi, we have to take her home. She needs to rest. I'll go pack her things.
Hey, beta, are you okay? So tell me this. There must be apples here, no, somewhere. Are there apples?
Papa.
Chavi, beta, go get me an apple. Ever since you left home, I haven't cut an apple. Go bring me one. Go. Knife! You always forget the knife.
Chavi! Chavi, no!
Oh my God!
No,
what am I going to do? It's okay, Chavi, it's okay, we are here now. No, Chavi, have an apple.